Hi friends, we are back with another how-to video. Today we're going to be learning how to draw a fun background. Have you ever drawn something and you're just like, oh my goodness, I have no idea what I want to do with the blank space behind the picture? Well, now you know. I drew a really quick sketch. We're going to draw a mountainy lake type sunset picture. So I drew that really quickly to give us a rough idea of what we're going to be drawing. And here's the thing. Since we're back at school, whether you have A days or B days, or if you're still on distance learning, we are going to put your artwork up that you draw from all the how-to videos in the cafeteria. And that is super cool, and I'm super excited about it. So guys, if you have drawn something, or if you draw this one, or if you go watch older videos and draw them, go ahead and bring your artwork to either me or Miss Shaw, and we will put it up in the cafeteria for everyone to look at. You can put your name on the front if you want everyone to know who it is, or on the back if you don't want anyone to know, but you still want to keep your artwork. And I heard through the grapevine that Miss Natasha keeps a lot of the things she's drawn, so if you come ask her for it, she'll probably give it to you, because what am I supposed to do with a drawer full of Pokemon characters and Among Us characters and whatnot? Alright, well, enough of that. So, we are going to hop right in. So, all we're going to need is a pencil. If you have colored pencils or markers or anything like that, that is awesome. If not, you can totally draw this with just your pencil. And it's actually really easy. That's why I picked it. It's pretty much just straight lines and squiggly lines. That's all. That's all. All right, so we're going to start out in the middle of, well, actually not in the middle, kind of like towards the middle of the bottom of our page. Go ahead and draw a straight line across, but not connecting the two sides. So let's see. I'm going to get something to make a straight line. And I'm going to draw it like so, but I'm not gonna connect it all the way. It's not gonna go all the way. So now that I have that one, that's gonna be the main big part of the scenery picture. We're gonna have the mountains and then the sun kind of going down over that. So that's gonna be our center. So now we're gonna draw just some short lines anywhere you'd like underneath them. Just like that. So I have two on this side, and I'm going to do two on this side as well. It doesn't matter where you put them. They're going to be the bottoms of your mountain. All right. So right now, it just looks like a paper with a bunch of lines. All right. So with the bottom, so this is the left side of my page, right side, facing you guys. I'm going to start with this one. And all I'm going to do is, from the corner of my paper, draw some jagged type triangles for the mountain. And then it can kind of squiggle down like so. So I went off the paper. Some jagged parts of my mountain, squiggle down, connect it. All right. Then I also have a line underneath that. So when you draw the squiggles on the mountains, go ahead and do it lightly, because your mountains are going to run into each other and we're going to actually be erasing some lines. I should have mentioned that before. All right. So the mountain that's underneath it, if you have a line underneath that, that mountain is going to run into the other one. So, let's see. I'm going to be coming off my page. Some squigglies. And I'll connect it like so. So, see how my mountain runs into that one? So, I can go ahead and erase the part that would technically be inside that mountain. And you can do it lightly first and then go over it in the end darker. All right, so we have those two mountains on that side drawn lightly. So now we can draw one of the mountains on the top. All right, so our main, one of our main mountains is going to come off our mountain on the left. So go ahead and draw a slope. So slanted line. And that's going to be part of one of the big mountains in the center. So I'm just going to draw two triangles. Bump, maybe another big one, and down. And I'm going to connect it onto the water. Yours does not have to look like mine. You can draw your mountains any way you want. This is just kind of a outline for it. So we have another mountain that'll be on the right side of our page. But we're not going to draw that in yet because we need to draw in the mountain underneath it. So we're going to draw in this guy first so that way the mountain coming off right here has something to connect to. All right. But you can connect on the left side the lake to the mountain. So the lake connects to the mountain. All right, so I'm going to start on this mountain. So I'm going to draw, I'm going to go up, make this one kind of big, kind of jagged, kind of squiggly, and connect it into the side. All right, so now that I have that mountain, I have something for this big mountain I want to draw over here to connect to. So that's what I'm going to do next. I'm going to draw a little guy maybe coming off the top like this, maybe some sharp jags. And I'm going to connect him right into that mountain and connect the lake. So see how it looks like this mountain's in front and this one's behind it? And then that main line you drew in the middle, you can just connect it. So that's going to be the lake or the ocean, whatever you want it to be. All right, so we only have one more mountain to draw. And you can make it as big or as small as you would like. Let's see. I think I'll have mine. I'm going to have mine not touching the other mountain. So I'm just going to go up, maybe give it a few slants, maybe come down, very particular about mine, I suppose. There we go. All right, so I have my last mountain drawn. So our page should look like that. It looks a little messy right now. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go back and we're going to darken the lines of the mountains. So if you're going to do it in pencil, if like you only have pencil, go ahead and darken it in pencil. If you have a marker or color pencil, go ahead and do them in black or brown, whatever color you actually want your mountains to be. They can be any color. I'll do it in pencil, just in case we only have pencil. And I kind of already drew one quickly. So we're darkening it up because we're going to give the illusion now of water around the mountains. And it's okay if it's squiggly. So it's a fun drawing because you can draw it behind. You can have it be the background of anything. So say if you draw a superhero, you put him in the middle of the page, or you put her in the middle of the page. Now you know how to draw simple mountains or water around it. And then everyone will be like, you're so cool, can I have your autograph? Maybe not, but worth a shot, right? All right, so I'm almost done with mine. And the next, we're going to draw the sun going down, the sun setting. I recently got to experience the moon rising. Everyone hears about the sun setting, but I watched the sun set and then I seen the moon rise. And that was pretty cool. I never seen it before. All right, so for our sun, it's just going to be kind of like an oval shape, because we're not going to draw a perfect circle because it's kind of be hidden behind the mountains. So do it really lightly. You want it to just kind of look like it's peeking over. So I did mine really lightly like that. And then I'm going to go ahead and go over it darker. If you're doing it in pencil, go ahead and do it in pencil. If you want to do it in red, go ahead and do it in red. If you want to do it in orange, whatever color you want your sun to be, that's what color you want to outline it in. All right, so now it still looks a little kind of confusing. What are we doing? Let's give the illusion of water. So if you're doing it in pencil, go ahead and do that. If you're going to do it in marker, follow along. So all we're going to do is just kind of darken the areas around the foot of the mountains. So I'll do mine in pencil. So I'm just going to find the edges and I'm going to darken them up, but occasionally making longer lines. So you're going to want to do that in all the corners of where the water would be touching or meeting the mountain. So I won't do it on every single one of mine, so that way you guys aren't staring at me so long. But this is kind of what it looks like. And you can get really good at it. You can watch a lot of YouTube videos. It actually is really, really cool, fun thing to do. It adds a lot to artwork. It gives it the illusion that there's other things there. But right now, I won't have you guys stare at me that long. So we're just going to all the edges. You can even put it underneath the mountains. So you could darken it up. Maybe kind of have it coming out a little bit. Like so. So then it'll really trick people into thinking that they're looking at that lake type setting. That ocean type setting. Alright, so I'll do a few more, and then we'll switch to the sunset. So if you only have pencil, the sunset might be a little difficult, just because you won't have the other colors. But you can still follow along, and whenever you do have colors, you'll know what to do. Alright, so, like I said, I'm not going to do mine all the way. That's just the idea. You guys get the gist of it. All right, so for the sunset, I have purple. I don't want blue. I'm going to do purple, orange, and yellow. I would do red. Red's my favorite color, but red is also the favorite color in the nest, and everyone uses it. You can also use like a pink-ish color. I've seen pink sunsets. But we'll just stick with what I have. So the sunset's actually going to be really easy too, because it is just a lot of scribbling, sort of. All right, so I'm gonna outline my sun in orange. So that way the colors don't mix with the pencil and bleed. We'll start with the orange. So all we're gonna do is go to the top and just kind of do this. We're doing a motion like that because it looks like it's kind of painting the sky. Like you've seen sunsets like that where the colors mix and it's just gonna be randomly. There's no wrong way to do it. There's no right way to do it because each sunset is different. They're not all the same. They're never the exact same. See how I have it kind of reaching out in different areas. And once you're like, all right, I'm sick of orange, or my orange is running out, like my oranges, you can go ahead and switch. And all I'm going to do is fill in that space around it with some yellow. And they're going to touch. So it's going to look like that. But I'm going to do the same thing with the yellow and reach out. It looks really cool when people do it this way when they're painting, or if you have markers that are kind of like paintbrushes. If you guys have seen those, it looks really, really cool. Or like Copic markers. Those are expensive, but they're fun. So I'm just going to go all around the orange. I'm going to fill in the areas. All right. And once you're like, okay, I'm sick of whatever color, that's when you switch to your other one. I only have 3 colors right now. You guys can have more than that. And I think maybe this purple might be too dark. We'll see. We'll just do it anyways. So I have the purple or whatever color you guys have, and that's going to fill in the rest of the space. So on the mountains, you'll just color in around the mountains. So see how it's going to touch it? It's going to fill in all that space. So I won't do that because you guys can look at one I've already done. Like I said, I did that very quickly. But there you have it. That is how you draw a fun sunset, mountainy background. You can put it behind a picture, or if you want to just draw like that. And like I said, if you guys have drawn any of the drawings in the past, or if you draw this one, bring them and we will put them in the cafeteria. And each month we're going to do a themed drawing. So in February, look out for some Valentine themed drawings. All right, well, that is it. And I'm excited, and I hope to see what you guys have. See you then.